The Maldives is a tourist paradise of blue lagoons and white sandy beaches. But in some parts of this island nation, the view has changed.
I'm sitting at our hotel. As you can see, the whole landscape is new reclaimed sand.
These tables used to be right on the edge of the water. Now they look out onto dump trucks, excavators, and an empty desert. This is the result of efforts to create new land in an attempt to protect the Maldives from sea level rise and boost its economy. It's an impressive feat of engineering, but it comes with a cost. My name is Jessie Chase Lubitz. I've come to the Maldives to see humanity's impact on our planet in person. Arriving in the Maldives by air, one thing is obvious. It's mostly water. Less than 1% of the area is actually land, and 80% of its islands are less than 1 meter above sea level. With global sea levels rising 3 to 4 millimeters per year, the low-lying islands could become uninhabitable by 2050. And the Maldivian authorities think brand new land could be the solution. The technology is complex, but the concept is simple. Huge suction pipes on boats move across the ocean floor, collecting sand like a giant vacuum. The boat then deposits this dredged material in a new spot to form so-called reclaimed land. And in the past 5 or so decades, the Maldives has created a lot of it. As we drive across the southernmost atoll called Adu, there's reclaimed land everywhere. As well as being higher and safer from sea level rise, the government says the new land will provide space for housing, attract investment, and develop local economies. But many people are skeptical about how the land will be used and whether it's worth the impact. From local Maldivians to climate specialists around the world, concerns about environmental damage are high.
So we're in day 2 of reporting from the Maldives. There used to be mangroves here, as far as we know. Over there you can see just a single mangrove trying to regrow. There is construction all around me, as you might be able to hear. And just across the way is reclaimed land with nothing on it right now, just a big empty patch of reclaimed land.
Underwater, the effects of the projects are even more noticeable. We went out snorkeling on an island near Male, the capital of the Maldives. Sand and sediment churned up by the dredging are suspended in what used to be clear water. And this is a big problem for ocean life. The sediment blocks out light needed for photosynthesis and can smother and choke the corals, stopping them from getting enough oxygen. To counter this, part of the land reclamation projects involved relocating large numbers of corals away from the dredging areas. Many of these corals have survived, but only a few are being monitored, so it's not clear if they'll all thrive in their new locations. And even if they do survive the trip, moving corals still has a big impact on the natural processes that form and maintain atolls, the ring-shaped structures that make up most of the Maldives. Normally, there's a balance between erosion and new sediments being deposited on the land. But by moving natural features like reefs and mangroves, these processes are being disrupted, which increases dependency on artificial barriers like seawalls. Coastal scientists warn that the changes being made today will require continued engineering on these islands for decades to come. And yet, despite the environmental impacts, many people say that the Maldives simply needs more land. But some people point out that huge swaths of the reclaimed land sit undeveloped, with locals lacking the money to build anything on them. In other cases, the reclamation projects are damaging existing businesses.
The hotel is obviously really upset about this. A lot of guests have come and asked for their money back to move. We've talked to lots of the staff here who are just kind of devastated by the fact that their view is gone. It's much hotter as well.
The tourist paradise of blue lagoons and white sandy beaches still exists here in the Maldives. But in trying to preserve this paradise, researchers worry that its government risks causing more destruction. And it's not just in the Maldives. No matter where you're watching this from, you're likely to have walked or lived on reclaimed land. From New York City to Scotland to South Africa, the UAE and China, land reclamation has already changed the shape of the planet. As the world reacts to rapidly rising seas and worsening storms, humans are attempting to change the layout of Earth on a massive scale. But in many cases, like the Maldives, the true consequences of these climate adaptations are yet to be seen.